something like this.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. I'll take a double on the hook.
Although it's going to be hard to throw even from that point.
She's so active. You know, she's always looking for something.
Look at Smith climbing her legs up over the top there to create space to come out the back door.
Well, use the momentum. Did you see that? How she did that? That was beautiful. Shifted her weight.
Rocky transition to the back, but yeah, she's leaving that knee in there. It's dangerous.
She's got a bunker leg for that, but that's going to be hard for Rocky to hit.
Yeah, Rocky's using that, you know, to take top position. She does have to really concentrate on getting that leg in the right position while she's doing these shots, because, you know, any transition could leave her in more trouble.
Oh, when she stretched her leg, that's the moment she can put it on. I didn't have Mari Smith upside down.
Now,
now she's free. There you go. Rocky's corner is actually asking to let her back up. Rocky disregarded that. She wants her top position again.
We're heading on.
Side choke, yep. But she turns away from it.
You have it.
And why strain that with her? With the braces, that should be okay. But is she underneath? Whoa, wait a minute. She's underneath? I can't tell
either. It's blocked out. But she is attempting to get her hooks in and stretch her out. That's, you know, the thing you can do from back position is if even if you don't have the choke, stretch them, lengthen their body out.
Looks like she's under the arm. Looks like she's under the arm. But I can't tell from this angle. Yeah, she's under her arm. Under the arm.
She's stalling. Yeah.
Nice.
Wow.
Nice scramble. Whoa, nice.
Yeah, we got to pull it up a little bit.
Arm and guillotine to create space for knees.
Good knees.
Engaging on an uppercut. Hard front kick. Those side kicks, she's turning her back a little bit on those, so she's got to be careful on that because Leslie can hop right in after that.
Now, it looks like Leslie's trying to put the pace on her now.
Yep. And Rocky again attempting a double leg, comes up to high hooks, but her head's in pretty deep. If it does go to the ground, she's got to make sure she clears the legs and doesn't get stuck in a guillotine.
She has that body locked up, but maybe she needs to fight inside, move her left arm.
Foot stomps. And back
the elbow. She needs to pull her left arm out. It's in too deep. Heads out. Good knees.
Leslie puts her on the cage now.
This is a high, this is a fast-paced fight right here. With Rocky being from Colorado Springs, I'm pretty sure she has nothing to worry about as far as conditioning.
Yeah, high altitude training is very helpful. But, you know, on the other hand, Leslie is a training machine. Like, we saw her war with Caitlin Young, the first war with it, and she didn't guess. And, I mean, those two were just going to town. I like the way that Rocky's using his head position to, I don't know, just get her, like, scrappy inside shots on her. You know what I mean? Like, Leslie's got length, so when she pushes her head down, she's able to launch her attacks.
Got to watch out for closing the distance to her. Oh, something's showing. They got it. Yeah, I think the referee should momentarily stop for a second, because once she turns into us, I think something's showing.
For those of you at home, you know, this is a professional event, and attire is it's an important thing to take into consideration. 10 seconds left in this round. I think there'll be enough time to make the suitable adjustments.
I think that's going to be okay, yeah.
Hard! Very hard to say who won this.
Uh,
Raquel, I feel like Raquel
I
won.
I thought Raquel won this round. Yeah.
Oppositioning. And Dan, and she was more authoritative with the knees and the positioning, the takedown attempts. She controlled the pace of the fight.
After this, you think after 3 minutes that still because she's constantly pushing?
Let's look at this this takedown by Rocky right here against the cage. She just kind of muzzles her down and beautifully, you know, staying locked. Like what Leslie has is on the ground is length. And Rocky's able to just kind of crunch in there and hold on tight. And look at this, you know, she uses that knee bar attempt to actually get top position.
Let's see what let's see what Leslie Smith, what adjustments she makes in this next round.
Yeah.
Let your hands go, Rocky!
Leslie's getting a lot more aggressive with those hands there, you know. Rocky's corner was yelling, "Let your hands go, Rocky!" And as they were returning, and I think I think they know, you know.
She throws only power shots. Rocky should throw two shots, three shots. Everything is one single shot. See, dang, dang, everything. It's never pom pom. She needs to open up something with a shot, and then the second or the third one hopefully connects.
She was very successful in the first round, but I guess she wants to disengage and throw more strikes here.
I like what Raquel's doing, throwing leg kicks and throwing kicks because Caitlin Young was pretty successful in the first fight.
Yeah.
She throws combinations.
Yeah, that straight jab overhand is actually landing very well for Smith.
It's because it's a combination.
Rocky needs to go back to throwing the inside leg kick because that's one thing that was really landing and working for real well.
It was. Inside leg kick to a right hand is going to land there. Nice fakes by Smith.
I feel like she's getting overwhelmed now. Smith's trying to overwhelm her, trying to take over this fight now.
She just throws by. Everything's a single shot.
Now, I know these two used to train together. They worked very closely together, and I'm wondering how familiar they are with each other's style or if they've noticed evolutions in each other. Or if they're not thinking and they just want to hit.
I feel like Leslie kind of wasn't surprised because now you see her, she's coming. She's still doing the same thing for the last round. Nothing's changed. She's still going forward, throwing more punches though. I think she expected the wrestling first round.
Yeah, Rocky is counting on a single shot, and she hopes one's going to hit it out of the ballpark, and she shouldn't do that. Throw two power shots. It doesn't matter if you connect them. Right after the inside low kick as well.
That's exactly. Not the range.
She's going to win like this.
She does a good job with those knees, though, you know, grabbing onto the head. Oh, nice jump right in.
Nice body hat. Spleen right hook.
One of my favorite combinations, actually.
I think that Rocky at this point needs to clench up and take it down to the ground again.
She needs to get her back off the cage and try keeping the center somehow.
Yeah, Leslie's doing a great job of keeping her at range with those long arms.
Yeah, look at that.
Rifling off those punches.
Combinations. That's the whole key to victory here.
She's slowly starting to overwhelm her.
I like the way Leslie will hold on her and then hit the body, hit the head, hit the body, hit the head. Nice.
She's a nice hockey fight.
Relentless.
Boom, nice. Look at that knee.
Beautiful. Rocky, you know, she's grabbing the head and throwing those inside those uppercuts. But I don't know, I just think Leslie's overwhelming her a little bit.
And I like the way Leslie's throwing that jab. Oh, nice body kick, right hand. Oh, look at this.
And the uppercut hook
right hand is there.
Right, it's right there.
But the thing is, I think she's too tired because she's getting hit clean and she's.
Yeah, but she's fighting doing from the first second.
She's fighting the pace. She's fighting the pace of Leslie Smith. Leslie Smith's put pressure on.
Psychic.
For every one punch, for every four punches Leslie throws, Rocky throws one.
Leslie's Helsley is known for her volume punching as well. You know, it's Rocky's had success with power shots
nice
in previous
knee.
Fights.
That was a hard knee. She felt that one. Now a front kick there.
A little damage on the cheekbone of Leslie Smith right now.
Nice body. Nice. That's a good. That's very nice here. From Pennington.
She's not getting out the cage. Leslie's like, come on. All right, get out the cage. Let's strike. Scrambles. I would say that's definitely Smith's round.
That was a great round right there. And now her confidence is shot through the roof, and round number three is going to be like that too. The corner of Rocky's got to tell her, if you land an uppercut, that means automatically you can add a left hook, which will also land. Boom, boom. I mean, come on.
So we have a one round apiece going into the third. Look at her rifling off those combinations, though. I mean, such a dominant round for Leslie Smith. You know, and it's not that Rocky wasn't launching her own, you know, attacks. It's just that Leslie was able to keep her at range.
And for those that don't know, Leslie Smith is wearing the black tights. Rocky's wearing the green shorts.
Did people confuse them at home?
Yeah.
Oh.
Here we go, ladies and
well,
gentlemen.
Well, if you hear me say single shots and you know what's coming next, you know right away what it is, right?
Oh, Leslie comes right out of the bat. Nice foot stomps from Smith.
But it's really good for the stretching, yeah, for balancing, putting the foot away.
Yeah, absolutely. It makes you want to defend that foot, and then the other one is giving up.
These girls are really fighting right here. Or should I say these ladies, or these women.
These fighters.
These fighters. Ladies.
Because they're just going, they're going
yeah.
at it.
I have yet to be disappointed by a Leslie Smith fight in the Vic, I'll say that. And Rocky just going toe-to-toe with her right now. She wants to be on the inside, and Smith definitely wants to have her on the end of, have her on the end of those punches. But when you back up to the cage like that,
move away. Up again. Like,
yeah.
Right. But that's good for her. For the next time, when she sees this, she's gonna know. Right up again, left hook, right up again.
I don't think she's grabbing the cage. Maybe she did, but
right up again from left elbow. That's a good. Nobody does that. Left hook right out.
They're in the range for that, for sure. Look at how she's reaching over the head, trying to secure an arm in guillotine. I don't know that...
It's not going to happen like
yeah,
that.
I don't think that this is going to happen because of the leverage that Smith has with her underhook. In fact, it could just put Rocky in a bad position on her back.
Smith should go for a knee tap and look to pass her on her right side.
Smith should make sure that her body's
oh,
now
wow.
on the other side.
All right, Rocky.
Just walk to the other side. The opposite side of her head is squat. She can lift her. Just squat, put one arm in between the legs, and lift.
I feel as though Rocky should have used that position like she did in the earlier round to pull the head down and just launch those knees to the body.
Yeah, you don't need to. You're wasting energy for nothing.
Oh, now Rocky's in the guillotine.
And that could be. It looks deeper to me.
It does. I think Rocky's got her hands in a position to move to a high crotch.
Yeah, she has high cross position.
She might even jump and catch that arm also. Oh, no, she doesn't. It wasn't locked.
She cannot afford a takedown, though. She needs to keep standing now.
Man, I almost wish she would use that left leg, just bring it up and kick.
Everyone wants to
and
see a super
needs to take this right to the ground, because
nice.
Then if she gets on top, she might pull it off a victory.
Come
come on, throw your shot. Boom, boom. I love the way Leslie Smith keeps pushing forward with us.
You know, I think
like,
that
no care.
Smith Delaney, I'm like, you just.
Yeah, Leslie Smith, she pushes forward. You have to fight, when you fight her pace.
A little taunting and cage taunting going on there. Nice kick.
Great showmanship.
Yeah.
Trading low kicks here.
They're going to feel it tomorrow. If I were Raquel Pennington, I would go for a takedown.
I would too. I would grab that leg and take it down, but I think Smith might be in her head.
Almost the last minute. That was cool combination.
Beautiful.
And right away it connects.
That double jab cross should have been there. Like, oh, don't leave with the kick. Yeah. Smith nice again is rocks it with those.
I really don't. This round is pretty close.
Well, I think that, you know, when you're watching this from home, that showmanship, it's just like, hey, come on, come over here. That definitely, nice, straight right, that definitely plays into the viewers at home and makes them think, oh, okay, she's owning this. And, you know, I think she's definitely had more volume in this round.
Yep. But you know, Leslie Smith pressed the action. Oh,
yeah.
I didn't take shots.
It's hard to win. It's hard to win a fight when everybody's seen your back against the cage the whole round. And I think that Pennington's actually throwing some really hard, solid shots. I just don't know that it's gonna.
She just didn't time to get it.
Nice flurry. Just walking straight at her like crazy.
Great way to end the fight.
Wow.
The grudge match.
Yeah.
I would mind seeing a part two for this.
I would love to see part two.
Wow.
Very nice fight.
That was cool. Fight the wall.
I gotta watch out when I wanna sing now.
Should get security up in there just in case, you know, they decide to brawl.
Oh,
hit me, hit me. Right away, a liver kick. Bang it, bang.
That was the left hook, right straight. Yeah. I love that combination.
It looked really good, too. I do think that the decision will be going to Smith.
I co-sign that, and I endorse that.
All that right, let's three. Find out what Joe Martinez has to tell us.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds, we go to the scorecards. All three judges have it, 29-28.
Yeah.
Your winner by unanimous decision, the Peacemaker.
Let's